Jiggy Jaguar, the 2008 Community Access Television Rookie of the Year, and the Jiggy Jaguar Radio Show on the network and JiggyJaguar.com.
We're back here on our big broadcast. We're going to go to Marilyn Redmond here in just a few moments. Find us on TuneIn, iTunes, Radio Loyalty, and of course Stitcher. Marilyn's going to join us here on the telephone to talk a little bit about her latest book. And amazing stuff happening today on our program. We are, I think, finally to the point where we are caught up. And Marilyn Redmond joins us on the telephone. Marilyn, first of all, tell us a little bit about your book. You've got an amazing, amazing book here.
Well, I have a very poor connection. I can hardly hear you, but I do am thrilled about my book is called Road to Success, and it's just out in paperback and available at Amazon.com or my website, angelicasgifts.com. And it's about looking at success from a new point of view than what most people see.
Road to Success, the latest book from Marilyn Redmond. She's with us today here on our big broadcast. And Marilyn, why did you decide to write this book?
Well, you know, most people look to other people to feed back. You know, I'm a success because I have a big house or a fancy car or a lot of money in the bank. And in my experience, that didn't bring a success to me. It was an inner void was still empty inside. I didn't feel successful because I had a job that was even a very rewarding job as teaching. There was a lot of things missing in my life, and I just did not feel successful. So I ended up with a devastating traumatic experience and discovered I needed to find a spiritual path, an inner path to peace and success rather than looking outside of myself.
We've got a great guest with us today. Marilyn Redmond joins us here on our big broadcast. Road to Success is the latest book, and Marilyn joins us here on the big broadcast. Now, give us a thumbnail sketch of the plot of the book, my friend. Kind of give us a look at the book here.
Well, it's actually four chapters, and the first chapter is called New Glasses Bring Success. So it's learning to change our viewpoint from looking outside of ourselves is what's out in the material world to changing our view to what's inside of us that's missing, and how can we fill the inner void so that we have a feeling of success and being fulfilled rather than from external reasons. And then the next chapter is Beyond the Barriers to Success. And we all have an ego that kind of tends to stop us from moving forward or getting past our fear. And so when you can see that the barriers are illusions, it's like when you drive down a road and there's a mirage on the road, it looks like water, but you drive up to it, oh, there's no water there. So our barriers are really illusions. And so when we can see what the illusions are, we don't have to believe in them anymore. We don't have to let them be the part that is motivating our lives because we're afraid to move forward or the unknown is scary or some people are afraid of success, actually. So we can ignore those barriers and not let them be the roadblocks that they used to be. And then the third chapter is about how I came to all this understanding and gives some history about who I am, what went on in my life to make my life change into looking in a new place for success. And it gives some of my family history and so forth. And the last chapter is a complete synthesis of how you can actually turn your life around by looking at the things that need to be addressed, such as your fears, your angers, resentments, guilt, shame, all those things that get in the way, and how you can actually turn them into a healthy, loving acceptance so that you can see that weren't really problems in your lives. You just didn't necessarily see the lessons they were bringing you. So the tools in the last chapter are very, very helpful. In fact, my publisher wrote a comment on the back cover of my book, and his comment, Patrick Young, said, Love Never Fails chapter in Road to Success is probably one of the most inspiring chapters I've ever read. Best wishes. And he was the publisher of my book. So I feel very proud and happy. I'm sure he's published a lot of books in his life, and that was a wonderful recommendation. So, you know, this book has a lot to offer people.
We've got Marilyn Redmond with us today. She joins us live here in our big broadcast, coast to coast, border to border on TuneIn, iTunes, Radio Loyalty. Road to Success is her latest book. Now, what elements did you draw upon to develop this book?
Well, it was really funny how it came together. There was some requests for people to write chapters for anthologies about success. And my writing was accepted into four books on successful anthologies. One was called The Book of Success, and there's, you know, there were actually four books. And I was accepted in part of those anthologies. And one day I was thinking about, gee, these chapters are really worthwhile, and what could I do to further help people get the information? And it came to me, well, take the chapters out of the anthologies and just put them into one book. And so that's what I did. I also have included poems that go along with the success of chapters. And I am also an artist, so I included some of my artwork in the book, and it came together in a, I think it's a very succinct, easy-to-read book, but it's very enthusiastic and lots of encouragement to move beyond your barriers.
We've got Marilyn Redmond with us today. Now, give us the profile of the typical reader who's going to love your book, Marilyn.
Well, if somebody's looking for inner answers, they're feeling lost and they don't know where they're trying to accomplish, or they think that, gee, if they're famous, they're going to be happy. If somebody's on a spiritual path, or people looking for answers to improve and enhance their lives, to make themselves feel more fulfilled inside and bring that peace of mind to them, because most of us have been looking for love in all the wrong places, and to find the answers within is very satisfying and very comfortable, and you feel a sense of contentment. And so anybody that's looking to enrich their life, improve their life, be happier, because as we remove more and more of the ego from influencing our lives, then the happiness can actually come into our life. The ego actually stops our happiness. So if you're looking for better ways to make your life happy, this is a good book for you.
We've got Marilyn Redmond with us today. She joins us live here on our big broadcast, coast to coast, border to border. Tune in, iTunes, Radio Loyalty, Stitcher, and of course the brand new Jiggy Jaguar app available in the App Store, jiggyjaguar.us. Now, why did you decide to write this book, and who's your target audience, Marilyn?
Well, I wrote this book because when I was a little girl, I danced ballet on a very stage in a theater in Seattle, downtown Seattle, and I looked at the marquee one day, and I thought, gee, if my name was up in lights on the marquee, I'd be a success. And as my life progressed and I grew up and went through college, became a teacher, and all the things that have a family, all the things you do, my life was not successful. In fact, it was very destructive, actually domestic violence time. So how do you become a success? Is it your name up in lights? Is that really what it's all about? And, of course, my life was going down the tubes. So I needed some new direction. And the target audience are people who are looking for answers that they don't know where to find them. I read lots and lots of books trying to get the answers. And through moving into a spiritual path, or a love, another word for loving, learning to love myself, and discard all the things that weren't loving, I could actually find the love within and open my heart and feel successful today. It's not because my name's in lights on a marquee. It's because I feel inwardly that I am a success in life, and it doesn't have to come from external places to make me validated that I'm doing a great job or whatever people recognize. I can just feel successful because I have accomplished changing my fearful life into a fearless life. I have moved my life from being a selfish person into giving to others and being a contributor to my community and those around me. And that's what brings success, is how are you sending your love out to others and helping them along their path. So I wanted to pass the messages along that I learned.
We've got Marilyn Redmond with us today. Marilyn, I appreciate you making time for us today. Thanks for coming on the radio, and we'll talk to you soon. Before we let you go, where can we pick the book up at?
All right, if you want to go to Amazon.com, it's available on my website. On my website is Angelica's Gifts, A-N-G-E-L, icasgifts.com. My book is available on my website. Or you can just Google Marilyn Redmond and my name will come up and my website will show up. And I also have a blog and lectures on YouTube. And so if people are wanting to contact me, I'm available at Marilyn@angelicasgifts.com.
Fantastic. Well, Marilyn, I appreciate you making time for us today, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks for coming on.
Well, I'm so happy to be on your show, James. It's just a delight. Thank you for having me.
Well, I appreciate it. We'll talk to you soon, Marilyn. Thank you. Marilyn Redmond with us today. We're going to take a time out. When we come back, oh, boy. More coming up.